Hi, my name is David Dalton, Clinical Director of Physiocare. I also have a specialist interest in lower limb biomechanics. Today, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about shin splints. Shin splints are inflammation of one of a number of structures that attach in and around the medial shin bone, otherwise known as the tibia. Why do people get shin splints? People get shin splints for a variety of reasons. I suppose the most common reasons would be, one, their biomechanics through age or time have deteriorated, and therefore the tendons on this part of the shin have been asked to do a job they're not used to, or two, they've increased their training and they're running more than they used to. Other causes could be a change in footwear, an increase in weight over a period of number of months, or an increase in activity or change in job whereby you're on your feet a lot more. What can be done about shin splints? Usually with shin splints, in the early stages or mild versions, rest is sufficient to settle them down. If rest doesn't work, you may need to look to non-steroidal anti-inflammatory gels. However, these are only treating the symptoms. From my experience with shin splints, the secret is to get to the root cause of the problem. Very often the root cause of the problem is a biomechanical abnormality or a biomechanical deficiency in some way. Hopefully, through a good program of exercise, strengthening and flexibility, maybe combined with some soft tissue work, that is enough to settle it down. If that is not enough, you may need to look to orthotic therapy to try and help correct the position of the foot to thereby offload the tendon that runs along the medial aspect of the shin. In certain cases, a change of footwear may be sufficient, or a change of running surface may be sufficient to allow your shin splints to settle. In severe cases of shin splints, it can veer towards what is known as compartment syndrome, and in those cases, surgical release is sometimes indicated. Usually, shin splints are best treated through a combination of activity modification, local physiotherapy modalities, and a good flexibility program. If that's insufficient, you may need to look to orthotic therapy. If you have any further questions on shin splints, please do not hesitate to contact us here at Physiocare.